to watching the Navy band, one of the top bands in the country, professional, of course, perform this piece. And then I found out that my friend, who's a college professor, conducted this with a community band of professionals. And it's a very mature sounding piece, and not easy. We have a special guest this evening who's going to be doing the narration for the night before Christmas. And Mr. McIntyre, who obviously is, if you're familiar, also not only on our school board, but was a teacher here for his career. He's an outstanding, not only person, an educator. I've taken a class with him. But what's really special on top of that is his son is in the band here. And so to have them on the stage at the same time is fantastic. So without further ado, Mr. McIntyre, with Larry. We have a few students that volunteered to actually enjoy the story right in front. Do I have them coming up? There's a few students. Where are they? There they are! Come to Grandma! Come! Look at it, we got a special carpet just for you. Come on! Enjoy! Pretend there's a fire behind you. There's a fireplace. They're eating. I don't know. Okay, here. Okay, without further ado, the night before Christmas, and thank you for coming out this evening. At the end, we need help to clear the stage. Thank you.
Thank you. Then, in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. Dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished like dishes of soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow. On his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth. The smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jello. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf. When I saw him, in spite of myself, a wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk.
And again, David, help on stage and clear. It was wonderful. You have a wonderful day, and thank you very much.